I speak on behalf of EuroCEF, that is the CRO arm of WePredict. WePredict provides different sort of solutions to the industry in matter of DMPK and safety, such as chemicals and biologicals, so hepatocytes, keratinocytes, skin tissues, and this sort of biological systems. So next, so our industry, I speak of the cosmetic industry, has been better equipped over the last few years in matter of assays, regulated assays, and more specifically in matter of the hazard characterization of the ingredients. So now there is a set of assays for identifying that hazard, meaning that it's a it's possible to classify the ingredients within with a yes or no answer in matter of sensitization. And also, of course, we keep the skin irritancy, the skin corrosivity, and the skin permeation assays that were regulated in the beginning of the 2000. So, for the formulation, of course, what the safety assessor requires is a risk assessment. And now there are two assays recently developed. Next slide, Barry. One called Sensis, the other called Guard. Both of them rely on genomics readout, and they are able to give the potency of the hazard and make possible a better safety assessment. The Sensis assay rely on a reconstructed epidermis. So in a way, it also integrates both the passage through the skin and also the skin metabolism that in many cases will give rise to the sensitization process more than the parent compound. So, and the domain of application of the Sensis is attractive because it allows to test lipophilic compounds as hydrophilic ingredients. The good thing, next slide, Barry. The good thing is that with that set of assay, it's the sensitization nowadays. Sensitization hazard is well characterized. So of course there is a debate on how to assemble the different assays because it may happen that they give conflicting results. So there are some rules now about how to choose the assays and how to reach the final conclusion. Also, what is new is that in matter of photosensitization, the Sensis assay gives preliminary promising results, and the different ingredients known for that danger were well classified by that assay. And to the point of today, in matter of finished products, again, these are new data, but it seems that the Sensis is able to give good information with a formulated product, a finished cosmetic product, and that's a big step for the industry. Because, next slide, Barry. Because nowadays, in matter of finished product, what do we have? Of course, the challenges are not toxicology challenges, because the paradigm of today is that the safety of the formulation will be guaranteed by examining the profile of each ingredient to draft the safety assessment. In the real life, many cosmetic companies they want to test their finished product more from a tolerance point of view than from a toxicology point of view, meaning they want to avoid discomfort of the product by the consumers. So it's not toxicology, but this is unpleasant, and eventually the consumer will not buy again the product. So there is that challenge, and there are also more subtle challenges, because the additive or the synergistic effect of ingredients contained in a formulation is not well documented today, and the scientific methods are at their limit, the scientific methods of today. So many industries, they still perform the repeated insult patch test, that is here to document the synthesization risk of the formulation. So that assay is still performed in certain countries in Europe, not in France, for example, not anymore, because it's considered as ethically debatable, but it's still performed in other countries. And that's why the new data about the census with finished product may give new solutions to the industry to replace that testing on volunteers. And of course, the other way to better document the finished product is to make use of the legacy data that are many in the companies through the use of modern in silico techniques and combinatorial informatic computational techniques. But this is not my domain, and I will give you I will give you the voice again, Barry. Thank you.